Hey, what is up, you guys? It's your boy Fabio. I am coming at you live on my day off right now. Just bumming it in some regular house clothes, didn't do my hair, just straight up chilling. I've got an exciting video for you guys today. We are going to be taking a severely in-depth look of my closet today with the help of this app that I've had on my phone for years that I've been waiting to utilize until this very moment. What you are looking at right here is a brand new iPhone X. I'm recording on my old phone. That's my 6 right there that you guys are coming to me with right now. What? Oh. Tinder notification. And this right here is my brand new phone. So why aren't I recording this video on this phone, you ask? Well, it's because there's an app on this phone that I want to use to show you guys. So I have to record on you to put the phone on this. I can see I'm shaking the whole camera with just an arm because the floor is that flimsy on the camera stand on the table. Shook. I'm an airbender. Oh, wait, I can do the whole thing. I can do the whole intro. Are you ready for this?
Water. Earth. Fire. Air.
And so the app in question is a really old, outdated application that still works completely fine. It's called Modman. It is kind of this menswear fashion app that kind of like shows you what's hot and what's trending. That's not necessarily how it functions anymore, and that's not how we're going to be using it at all. It's really old. It like stopped getting updated around like iOS 8 or something like that. I might be wrong. This thing still could be active, but it's literally like not what I use it for. There's one feature of this app that I'm super excited for that I can't wait to show you guys.
Okay, so to put it plain and simple, this app allows you to take pictures of your clothes and organize them by labels, and after you get your whole closet in here, you can customize outfits and save them so you can virtually pick what you want to wear for the day before you even get out of bed. Right here, you can see some of the categories that I have. These are a pair of shorts, and under the notes, I put that they're brown and tan, so whenever I'm looking for a specific short, I can just do that, and only whatever word matches will come up. So you can get really specific with trying to find your stuff. And I have its size and what season it's for, and you know, if it's casual or dressy and the brand and everything. And what we are going to do today is do this to my entire closet. Properly label it, take all the pictures, and as soon as I'm done with that, I'll show you all of the outfit building features and whatnot. All of the outfits show up in your lookbook. I don't have any yet because I haven't done anything yet. The reason why I waited to get a new phone to do this is because I painstakingly took hours to do this for this phone right here. And then, oh, what up, Jose? What you need, son? For this phone right here, I had to like reset it for something, and all of the pictures and information was within the app and not on the phone. So when I reset the phone, I lost all of my closet details, and now that's not going to happen to this one. So let's see what Jose wants. What up, dude? Come with me Monday morning. Oh, there we go. So just like a couple more things that this app does, it shows you like what's up for today. This always says no looks today, and it's never really updated, so I don't care for this at all. I don't use this for anything. You can click on most popular and see just like stuff that they have, I guess, which isn't really loading for me at the moment. Oh, but there it goes. And then here's like the shopping tab, so if you're looking for something in particular, it just like, I guess, pre-recommends you for stuff that's already on the app. And then you can look for inspiration, and I have no idea what that is or what it means. Oh, you can follow their Tumblr. Okay, so I guess this app is pretty cool. I don't really care for any of the shopping aspects of it. I only care about saving my whole closet into this library. So without further ado, I'm going to move my lights to point towards all of my clothes, and we are going to get started on photographing everything.
If I look sweaty, it's because I am. I'm currently in an attic and there's no air up here, so it's just heated from the sun like through the roof. So I'm just chilling in my sauna right now. But before we get started on the process, I'm gonna show you guys how this works. I've got a pair
of dope vans right here that I want to take a picture of and save, so I'm gonna show you guys how to do that.
Probably not gonna be able to see this well. I'm just like eyeing this through the camera. Actually, well, let's see what feats I'm willing to go through. Yeah, there we go. Okay, hi, right behind you. So we have our clothes. What we're gonna do is go up here to the camera and then it'll let us take a pic of the shoes. So, is that good? Well, not technically. I don't want it to look like that, but that's just to show you guys. I'm gonna retake it real quick. Okay, that's a good one. So we're gonna use that, and yes, that's how I'd like it cropped. Okay, and under the notes, I'm going to type in that these are Vans, and that they are navy, and also tan. These are shoes. Their style is casual, and their season is all. I can wear them anytime. Brand Vans. I guess I didn't need to put Vans here. Oh, pro tip. I'm glad I'm showing you guys this right now. I don't know if it's just because of my particular keyboard. I obviously have like a swipe text thing, but my keyboard doesn't like go away whenever I'm trying to like hit on anything else. So if you're facing this problem, to make it go away, just go to like any of these categories right here and tap on it, and it'll bring that stuff up instead, and then you can readjust yourself. So in the notes, just delete Vans, I don't need that. And so, got all the categories, again, click on one of the drop-down menus to make it go away. Size, doesn't really matter. I don't have to put in price or size because I don't care. You can even do this as a wish item. So if you could like take a picture of this like in a store and then mark it as a wish item as something that you want, so you can like remember that you like it and go get it whenever you can. And I just keep the available thing on because I have it, so of course it's available. I guess you could switch that off if it's unavailable, if you like wore it already and it's in the wash and like in your dirty clothes pile and you haven't done laundry yet. So that'd be good. Then you could filter it out of your outfit options whenever you're building one. And that's all we need, so we had done. And now it's there. And I can actually, because that kind of works, I guess I can demonstrate how to make an outfit right now. So tap the plus icon. I don't know what's happening. Maybe I tap on that. Yes, okay. This bottoms shoes. Tap over here. Top. Shorts, shoes, done. And I can save it as a look, just like that. And that's what we're going to be doing after my entire closet's done. And spoiler alert, this right here is not my entire closet. And so we just took a picture of the shoes through the app, but you can allow the app to access your photos and import from your camera roll. I don't know why my camera roll's all the way down there. And just put in all your clothes from there. I'll do this one really quick as an example, because it's a shirt that has a front and a back. So I tap on the two photos to add it, and it's a shirt, it's a tee, it is really casual, and it's a, oh no, that's more pictures. And it is spring and summery. In the notes, I want to type in that it's red, not that red, that red. Click on a drop-down thing to make my keyboard go away. No, not all. See, I'm sorry, I'm doing this looking through my camera. So I'm not actually looking at my hand, but you know what? I guess I could do that instead. Select photos, red. And it's weird, it's not letting me, it didn't let me select what brand it is, which is weird. And it actually just popped up like two things, which is also weird, but let me figure this out real quick. Okay, so I'm back in the edit section. It turns out you can only have one photo per article of clothing per saved item. So unfortunately, you cannot have front and back pictures of whatever shirts or pants you may have with graphics on either side. I could have sworn I was able to do this earlier, and I'm probably just not figuring it out. What this is looking like right here, yeah, is that like it's only allowing one picture for some reason. And also what I found out that in order to delete it, you come down here after you hit edit. Whenever you select to delete it, it'll force quit because it thinks so hard about deleting it that it just boop. Yeah, so that's unfortunate, but it will delete it. But as far as I'm concerned, you cannot do front and back pictures of your stuff. And I must reiterate, I swear you could at some point. I don't know why I thought that. Hi. But I'm fairly certain that if you take a picture of your clothing and it has a back graphic, I think you could remember. Oh, hi. I'm pretty sure you can remember if a shirt of yours has a graphic on the back of it or not, so you'll probably be okay.
Oh man, broke a sweat leaning up against the wall that's behind that camera. So without further ado, this is the part where I start photographing this entire closet. Won't waste your time.
sweating up a storm up here. I just successfully took a picture of all of the clothes that I own. Earlier, as you remember, I said that you can't exactly put two pictures on one thing. Well, early in the process of taking pictures of all of my stuff that had a graphic on the front and the back, I decided, you know what, it'll be completely fine if I have two separate search results for the same shirt, because it just won't matter. If I'm searching for a specific shirt, it'll just have the front and the back pop up, so I know that one is connected to the other. So I did end up taking pictures of both the front and back of all of my graphic tees, if they had any back graphics, and so those will also appear in the app whenever I put them in. So now that we've taken a picture of everything, it is time to label and categorize everything. I will be back to finish this video in I don't know how long, maybe a few hours, because it is time for me to individually label and categorize and save all of these photos. And then after that, we can finally build some outfits with virtually my entire closet in my hands. Woo! Holy shit, you guys. It is literally 10 o'clock at night the next day. It took me hours collectively to individually upload and categorize all of those clothes, but I finally did it. It was just a little bit tedious, but I got it all done even though I didn't necessarily have to. I just wanted to have detailed labels on my clothes, so all I could do was search for core keywords and find them at the snap of a finger. So that's what we did. It'll probably be a lot easier for you guys since you 90% chance have less clothes than I do. Not saying that you do, but you know. But it's finished and I'm so happy about it. Now my whole closet is right here, and now whenever I buy new clothes, I'll just immediately take pictures and label them so I don't have to keep doing this update in like gigantic hauls. But oh my god, was this so much. It took me hours collectively, but probably only a couple hours like diligently doing it. Any other time I was kind of just like doing it on autopilot in the background while focusing on something else. I FaceTimed a couple people and talked while doing this. I listened to music a lot. I listened to a ton of music. And I actually wasn't expecting to have 2 days off in a row. I checked the schedule the morning of and I was like, huh, well, I guess I don't work. So I just did this all day and now it's 10 o'clock at night. Woo! But I saved the most fun part to share, especially with you guys. Now we're going to look through my entire closet on my phone and build and save outfits so we never have to worry about what we're gonna wear another day in our lives. Are you ready? It is so sad that I am actually excited about this.
Okay, you guys, and here is my entire closet in the app Modman completely finished. This is the result of just getting all my stuff in there, and it's really beautiful. You'll have to forgive me if I like get out of frame. I'm having to like simultaneously look at this like in real life and on the camera. But oh yeah, I also gotta speak quietly because I'm like right here too. But let me just show you a few examples of, oh, hi, bye, of what we can do in this app. I wanna pull up the magnifying glass and let's say that I need to wear something blue tomorrow. I can just type in blue. Here's all of my blue stuff, whether it be jeans, shirts, tanks, anything that has blue on it. Get rid of those. Let's say that I want to take a look at all of my H&M stuff. I can just search the name of the brand and there it all is, because that's how I tagged it. That's one of my favorite hoodies. I got it with the Weeknd's fall line that he did with H&M. That's actually his last one after H&M's marketing debacle off of that whole monkey in the jungle thing that I don't necessarily remember. But I've got it sorted by, you know, its season, its style, its brand, and the size, and then these are the notes, and I can type in any of those keywords and find this, and then build an outfit with it. So, I said we're going to build some outfits, and that's exactly what we're going to do, but before I get to that, I must talk about a couple problems I had with the app,
and that is it force quit on me pretty often, which was unfortunate. It'll force quit on you if you like move too quickly. Like I was like trying to like edit and then type all this and then finish it all and then go on to the next one and then edit, and it would like crash on me. But and again as I shown you guys way earlier before in the video, it does crash whenever you like try to delete something. It will delete it, but the app will just crash. You'll just have to reopen it. And sometimes I would be like editing like notes, and then I would, you know, finish it all and put okay, bullhead size medium, and then finish, and when I hit finish it would force quit, and then I'd have to do it again. And so, you know, that's just the way that it went. But we're gonna go to our lookbook and we're gonna create some outfits, and I already have one in particular that I know I wanted to do. And the first thing that we're going to do is search the word striped, and we are going to find a t-shirt that's Crooks and Castles. Yes, I love that shirt. It's navy striped, but only halfway down. That little print right there says Crooks and Castles. Not, you can't really see it because it's, you know, a camera focusing on a picture that took an out of focus picture in the first place. But that'll be the head of our outfit, and then we'll go over here again. And a good complement to navy blue is tan. So I'm gonna search tan. And we've got some fireworks going on outside, if you can hear that. I live in the ghetto, so sometimes they're not all fireworks, but those are like little crackly pops, so I'm sure those are fireworks. But it's also only July 2nd. Oh, I forgot those were there. It's also only July 2nd. No, gunshots don't echo like that. But the fireworks have been going on since like mid-June, so. I'm going for a nice little summer nautical fit, and by searching tan, I managed to find both of the remaining pieces of this outfit. So I'm just gonna drag and drop both of them in there, and then we can hit done on this, and now I can just drag it all out. We've got some, okay. Oh, and another good note, if you're going to be doing this yourself, is to only get like exactly the clothing in there, because this can be annoying. But I guess I can overlap it like that. So it's best to, you know, real life advice and on this app, it's best to build an outfit from the bottom up. So we've got these Vans Chima Ferguson Pros. They're navy with tan gum. We've got these bullhead jogger shorts from PacSun from like 2016 that perfectly match the shade of gum. And this Crooks and Castles long length tee, also from PacSun, but probably no longer carried because it's a couple years old, perfectly matches the navy on the shoes. This is a solid summer outfit. It's a little bit nautical because of the stripes, and I love that. And the tan is a beautiful complement to the navy, especially with my skin tone. Navy and tan is just a really great complementary thing that, you know, works well with if you have tan skin. So wear navy if you're tan or brown. And we're just gonna hit done on this outfit and save it. Oh my god, what am I even going to note for this? Well, first of all, for the occasion, it's a good day fit for the summer, and its style is casual. And as for notes, I really don't know. I guess I can just put the same notes that I always do, striped, and then maybe Vans, just to clarify on the shoes. Boom, and now that's a look. Cool, we have our first look down. Let's add another one. This is the part where I actually don't have like anything planned, and we're just going to build whatever. So let's say that I need a really good date night outfit. I already have one item in particular that I know for a fact I love to wear on dates. We are going to check outerwear, and then we're gonna check jackets. And there it is. This is a navy Gap windbreaker that I love to death. I wish I could have gotten it in red, but they were on sale and didn't have it in my size. Now, I could pair this with probably a nice plain like undershirt, because a graphic tee to me is like kind of just like too much when you're going on a date. You really want to simplify things because you're really trying to sell yourself and not like some kind of image that may be on display that could be misrepresented if you were to wear your personality on a shirt. We're gonna be talking about dating advice. That's gotta be a whole separate video. So let's just keep going with finding a top. Get rid of all of this mumbo jumbo. And I really like dark, solid colors because they're kind of romantic. And whenever you have a deep saturation, that kind of just like reflects the tone of like what I'm all about, especially when it comes to going on a date. I don't know if this is making any sense because I'm just rambling. Stripes is a little too much. That's a shirt that I got when I was like 10 when I went to Las Vegas for the first time. I can't believe I got it so big so I can fit into it now. It's from the Venetian Hotel. That's a good sweatshirt. I love that. That's from Zara. That means to run away. Yes, okay, let's go with... No, we can't. We can't. Shoot, what could possibly match this jacket that we've got? That's pretty handsome, but that's like a staple piece in of its own. I'd have to wear that by itself. Ah, okay, that can work wonders. We've got some blue in there already that'll match, and it's an incredibly simple graphic. And now for some pants. Let's just hit the category bottoms and just see what comes up. How many chinos do I have? Like, not any at all. Casual pants. This is like all my joggers. Ignore like the Team Jacob tribal pants. That light color could work just fine. That's like a really smooth, like eggshell, kind of like taupey color almost. It's like basically the color of like a house. But what we can do is pair this jacket and baseball tee together in a nice layering. You wouldn't even be able to tell that the baseball tee is a baseball tee because of the long sleeves on the jacket. And now all we need is a good pair of shoes to help cooperate. And we can just hit category all and... I love my houndstooth Janoski Maxes from Nike. These things serve me really well and they go with everything because they're houndstooth, which is a really fine, like, black and white. You're not gonna be able to see it very well in this. Honestly, what am I doing? Oh, shoot, that's the wrong way to go. I need to, no, that's the wrong way to go. This iPhone X is new, people. That's what we want. I'm sorry to keep you guys in the dark. No, pun intended. There we go. And so, houndstooth, beautiful pattern. I can make it small, I can make this smaller, and we kind of just organize it the way that we want it to, and then evenly do those out. I'm actually severely impressed I could touch both of those with each finger and move them around independently, and then we'll save this one as an outfit as well, and the app just force quit. Sweet. That's what we get for trying to do all this progress. This is a good opportunity to review what I have under my shopping category. We shop from A to Z, which is ASOS to Zara. Good British brand, Hollister is a staple in my closet. Abercrombie and Fitch, not so much. Bonobos is amazing. Modman is what we've been working on. H&M is a critical staple. Topman is great Brit stuff. Amazon for those cheap individual, really unique finds. And Zara is just the bougiest of the bouge. Then we've got all kinds of stuff that doesn't matter, like Target, Dick's Sporting Goods, Forever 21. Redbubble's good for, again, really unique stuff. That's where I get some of my like pop culture stuff. Wish for shit that's pennies on the dollar. Vineyard Vines if you're feeling a little bit Republican. Pink if you're feeling a little bit Democrat. Just kidding. And Fashion Tap is like a fashion-oriented social media platform that I haven't touched in years. And oh hey, look, that's me from last year. I wasn't even expected to be like signed into this app whenever I opened this. Like I haven't touched this since my phone was brand new. Yeah, it's just like fashion inspo and really cool stuff. That's kind of a look similar to the outfit that we were building that I wanted to go for. It's a really simple date night look. You look clean, you look handsome, you look sharp. The jacket honestly makes the whole thing. So get a good date night jacket is what I tell all my friends to have. That's one of my best friends, Abdullah. I took that coming on 2 years ago. And yeah, I mean, what else do I have on here? Only 7 posts, but 23 followers. That's pretty damn good for something that I almost never touch ever. So back to Modman. It's shat out on us. We're gonna go to lookbook. I wanna try one more thing. We're just gonna create a new look and we're just gonna play around. I need something really streety to wear and I already have something in mind. This is all my red stuff. I want this Hollister flannel because that's the shit. And I have these pants. I call these like my shinobi joggers because they're really badass. And they're these black bullhead. Yes, there they are. They're these black bullhead moto joggers right here. And they have like zippers on the ankles and the And the knees are moto padded and the drawstring is really long and it kind of looks like a tie that you would wear in like a karate gi or something. Not like a belt, but like, you know, something that would hold your gi together, like the little flimsy strings that keep it all in place. And we are going to put a little bit of a Dragon Ball Z spin on it. I wonder what happens if I search boot. Oh, nothing, because I still had the bottoms category on. So then maybe search boot now? Oh, no. Oh, I have it subcategorized as boots. So I need to hit shoes and then boots. But then there they are right there at the top. These are Under Armour, like military boots. And they're like the only high shoes that I have. And I just absolutely love the way that they look because whenever I tuck joggers or any pants for that matter into them, they just look dope. And the only thing we're missing here, because I wear my flannels open, I don't wear them buttoned. I could wear them buttoned for a very simple clean look and this could be a whole outfit just on its own. But I do want a graphic tee since I leave my things open and we're going to need a black one on account of the black joggers. So we're just going to type in black and then go to our shirts and subcategory tees because that's how I have it done. We've got a Black Panther tee. This is, Akatsuki. That would match the red, but that's a little too much, I think. Diamond Supply with a red gem. And as I was saying, that this Black Panther tee is from Kendrick Lamar's official website. I got it. You can watch it in another one of my hauls, but I think we're gonna go with the signature Starboy tee. That's official from The Weeknd's website as well. Or I could just contrast the red and put a flag of Bosnia shirt on there. Oh, we've got, why do I have so much black and red stuff? That shirt would work, the Lil Uzi Vert would work. This Reckless one would work wonders, but and this would add a lot of versatility to the outfit if it was really hot outside in the summer and I wanted to tie the red flannel around my waist, because then that would allow you to see the backside of it, which is this, which has all these different provinces of Japan on it, or cities, I should say. So we'll just stick with Starboy, because that's what we already have on there, and orient it as such, and then hit done. Didn't force quit on us this time. So I'll just type in flannel, XO, and then put the occasion. This is a good date night outfit too, so I'm just gonna put evening. I'd kind of die wearing that in the daytime if it were hot. So the fall and winter when it's nice and cool give us an excuse to wear those boots in a timely manner, and this is going to be casual for us. And then done. And there you go. Now you can just start building looks on looks on looks now that your closet is completely within this app. Oh, where on date? Cool. Oh, okay. So this is where the schedule comes in hand. So you can remind yourself when to wear this outfit. Like if you had like a special occasion, you're like, okay, gotta remember to wear my suit with the floral button up and this, that, and the other. And you'll be like, dope, and your phone will remind you. So that's pretty fantastic. And then I guess it can also show you what outfits you most use. I guess if you do that and keep a counter, then you can kind of see what you wear a lot and then be like, oh, okay, well, I seem to be wearing this outfit a lot. I don't want to tire it out. So let's switch up with something else and maybe try something new. So that's my whole in-depth review of this app, I guess. This app, once again, is called ModMan, and you can download it for free in the App Store. I wasn't paid to do this. I've literally had this app on my phone for years. And as I said in the beginning of this video, I never wanted to do all of this work until now when I got a new phone, because I suffered from one instance where I had my whole closet already in my phone and something happened where I needed to reset it, and then my whole closet just wasn't there in the app anymore, even though I re-downloaded it. That's the only risk. My only cons of this app is that exactly what I just said. If you delete the app, you lose your whole closet because the data doesn't keep. This isn't something you like sign into or anything as far as I'm concerned. And it force quits often, like when you just saw me trying to save that previous date night outfit. But it is all good in the hood, and it's something that's really simple that you can just do again. And those are my only gripes. It's a pretty fantastic app. I'm gonna be looking forward to spending much more of my time building outfits so I can quite literally just look at my phone, choose what I wanna wear for the day, and then get up and get it out of my closet without having to really hunt anything down or search for it or worry, because I'll tell you something, with this amount of clothes, I worry that A, I ironically don't have anything to wear, or B, that I don't know how to dress because of just all these options. But if you take the time now to put it all together, then you won't be suffering later. This video's reaching a ludicrous amount of time, so I'm just gonna call the outro right here without even, you know, moving back over to my usual spot where I address you face to face. I guess I could do that right now. Yay! There you guys are. Okay, cool. So, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. And subscribe if you like to see more fashion stuff. Fashion is, in fact, a passion of mine, and I do a lot of fashion stuff here, including bi-monthly hauls and all kinds of stuff. I want to start giving advice, and you can follow my Finsta, my fashion Insta, that is, which is Fashion by Fabio on Instagram, of course, and see what I'm up to there. I'm actually about to go record and post some content for it now because I haven't touched it in months. I've been way too lazy with a lot of my videos, but we've got some time on our hands now, and I'm doing that foreign thing where I keep bringing up new things to talk about whenever I'm trying to say goodbye, so I'll just cut you guys loose. Thank you so much for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe. I'm sorry. Comment down below what you think I should wear. Like, give me suggestions of things that you think I would look good in, or whatever you want to see me review, or what I should wear, or just things that you want me to take a look at in general. And that would all be greatly appreciated. So thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys. See you later. Bye. Bye.